Leo, hi. Thank you so much for joining us today. Start us off by telling me a little bit about the Spartan Lacrosse Academy.
Yeah, so it's a company we started in 2013 when I was at Colgate University. Came back in the summer and my dad said, you know, you got to work. You can't just do nothing all summer and play lacrosse. So he decided to run camps out of a local local turf field. And we ran, you know, 1 week the first year, and then it went up to four, and then up to six and eight. And then once I was done university, it kind of grew to being a full-time year thing while we played. And, you know, now we're in leagues, we have camps, we do school visits, and it's kind of just growing lacrosse in our hometown of Kitchener-Waterloo.
So when did this start? Was it this year or before this year?
So 2013 was actually the first camp.
Okay. Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, so 2013 when I was in university was the first camp we ever ran, and that was just 1 week, and it was during the summer. And then now we have stuff going on from teaching little kids, U9 and U7-year-olds how to play. We go do school visits where we teach kids that have never picked up a sport before. We bring in sticks and we teach them lacrosse, and then we also kind of do the elite training where we bring in some players like Craig Wendy and Brandon Robinson and some guys to teach our kind of higher level U18 group. But the goal of the company was just to kind of grow the game of lacrosse here in the hometown of Kitchener-Waterloo, and then also in Ontario. You know, numbers are astonishingly low in Ontario, and Ontario being the number one feeder to the NLL at, I think, like a 60% rating. 60% of the players in the NLL are from Ontario. The sport dying in Ontario is kind of crazy to see, with it growing so much in the NCAA in North America as a whole.
Yeah. Now, I read that you're giving free lessons to kids, you know, to help keep them active throughout the pandemic and to help grow the game. So is that a part of your lacrosse academy, or is that something entirely separate?
Yeah, so it's all underneath the Spartan Lacrosse Academy.
Okay.
Kind of umbrella, if you want to call it that. And yeah, so grassroots is kind of the biggest thing that I think the sport of lacrosse needs. We want to be inclusive. We want to have everybody try it. And I believe in Ontario, I might be wrong with the US, but we really focus on the elite players, the top level players. So the house leagues, the development, minor development leagues, they're falling by the wayside. They're less and less development leagues are in Ontario. So when you start lacrosse here, you start at that rep level, that all-star level, which is kind of unfair and kind of deters players from joining the sport. So we want to allow players to kind of try the sport and have a development level to try it, and what better than kind of doing a free lacrosse day where parents don't have to pay anything and they can try the sport for free, and then join into one of our leagues to develop their kids before being that all-star or that elite level player.
So I know you said the Lacrosse Academy has been around since 2013, but these free days that you do, how long has that been a thing?
So we work with local organizations. Ontario Lacrosse Association is the basically the governing body that looks over lacrosse in Ontario. And they have local organizations around in each city, pretty much. And we work with them to do free try-it days. Now with the pandemic and everything going on, they weren't able to run it this year. So we decided to jump on and say, okay, we'll take over some free try-it days where we book the field and do basically skills and drills for the kids to try the sport. But previously, it was being done, and it is still being done by local organizations around Ontario and around Canada.
You know, you mentioned grassroots and using it as a means to grow the game for kids who might not be playing at an elite level. Have you had a lot of success in that so far?
Yeah, so we're really trying to grow kind of that U7, U9 age group. Growing that age group, like it says, it filters through the older age groups, and you got to start with the younger ages to be able to keep it going. So no, it's been good with more kids signing up, and I think just kids knowing the game and hearing about Canada's national sport is our main goal. It's just getting them to understand what lacrosse is first and why it's our national sport. Obviously, the Indigenous people giving it to us, and then having the opportunity that anybody can play it and anybody can pick it up.
So you guys teach that to kids, you know, where it started and the roots of the game and all that?
Yeah, I think especially when going into school visits and stuff like that, and even teaching our U7s, the little guys, when they come and play, that's the greatest game about lacrosse is the greatest thing is that it was given us by Indigenous people. I think no other sport is like that. I think no other sport has that cultural benefit. I'm not Indigenous, but playing in Six Nations for 5 years with the Six Nations Arrows, and then now coaching them and having the honor to coach them, it kind of shows what lacrosse really is, and I think everybody, whatever ethnicity you are, learning what's behind the sport of lacrosse is almost as cool as playing the sport of lacrosse. There's so much history behind it.
Yeah, fully agreed, 100% on all of that. Now, in the meantime, if anyone wants more information, should they follow Spartan Lacrosse Academy on social, or do you guys have like a call to action?
Yeah, we got our website. So our website has all the information from when our free try days are going to start to our league, hopefully going on outside in the summer, to anything that we may be doing, you know, former training, Instagram videos, whatever. We have it all on Instagram or Facebook and obviously our website.
All right, awesome. That's all I had for you. Is there anything that you want to add that I didn't ask?
No. Obviously excited for, I was talking to Michael before, you know, excited for the new year with the Riptide and being lucky enough to get picked up by them with Dan Levisser and Jimmy Veltman. And then obviously some great pickups with Callum Crawford and Gibson and Dan Teat. So really looking forward to getting back whenever that may be. And the NLL players are ready as much as I believe the fans are ready to get back going.